Camera traps have quickly become one of the most useful and ubiquitous tools for ecology and conservation. These traps give us an unprecedented view into what the animal world is like when we're not around. This view, though, can still be further expanded. Welcome to the Panatrap Project. This is an endeavor to build and test commercially available 360-degree virtual reality cameras and turn them into DIY camera traps for studying animals on their own in the wild. While traditional camera traps are a super useful tool, they still have several problems that we haven't been able to really get over. And probably the biggest one is placement bias. A normal camera trap has a very narrow field of view, maybe about 70 degrees or so, of where it can actually detect an animal and take a photo and capture it digitally. This means that the researcher is actually having to make decisions about where to place this camera in the hopes that an animal might pass through here. That messes things up a little bit scientifically, as well as it just limits a lot of the other scope of which they're trying to capture animals that might pass behind it. With 360 camera traps, there hopefully is going to eliminate placement bias because it actually captures a full photosphere around the entire camera. Meanwhile, in the tech world, there's been a ton of investment into virtual reality systems, which a key component is 360-degree virtual reality cameras that can very quickly capture incredibly high-resolution photospheres of everything surrounding them. And these have been driven down in price, and the quality has gone up significantly. Thus, for the Panatraps, our goal is to make and design attachments for these readily available 360 cameras that anyone can quickly connect, build, and turn their own camera into a ready-to-go 360-degree camera trap they can go place out in the wild and start finding out what's living out there. So what we've done is we've created a couple different designs. We've tested over 6 cameras in terms of how high of quality the image resolution is, as well as their sensitivity to things like IR light to see what would make the best 360 camera for our camera traps. So we successfully hacked 2 of the most popular commercially available 360 cameras, the Xiaomi Mijia or Mad V in the US and the Ricoh Theta V camera. Both of these are quite good cameras around the $300 to $400 range. And we've successfully controlled them and turned them into camera traps. We've posted detailed public open source build instructions for how you can assemble one of these yourself today using very simple prototyping tools such as a 3D printer or a laser cutter if you have one. We've gone then and actually physically tested these in jungles nearby in Panama, on nearby islands, as well as other harsh environments and different environments, such as the colder cloud forests around Panama. This thing can run for days and days and days and captures great, incredible photos. So those are the 2 current prototypes we have now. We're hoping to keep hacking more cameras and be able to add more of these devices to our library of what cameras you can use with the Panatrap. So these 2 camera traps we've developed are already working out quite great so far, and we're having lots of fun testing them out, using them in the forest, and seeing what we can find and what do we do with this new type of data we're getting from them. For future developments, though, our first priority is just getting these designs out and publicly available as wide and far spread as possible so that others can see what our design's like, comment, and give good feedback and ideas about it, and hopefully be able to build their own so that they can start testing and going through this process with us. Our next steps are there's a handful of initial tweaks and slight alterations to the design that we're already coming up with just from using these bad boys out in the field. And then finally, and probably most importantly, is we're looking for funding sources for our laboratory to continue the development on devices such as these so that we can hopefully keep developing and literally broadening the scope of the whole world of camera traps. So if you know of anything or you're looking for a cool project to help fund, let us know. We're eager and ready to work and continue developing these cool new tools for science.